Hi traders, Friday, short trading day. Riot is up 22%, high volume. Blockchain company, Bitcoin related, over 60 now. Wanted to go long over 60, assuming it's going to go over the highs, and it did. Looking great, just moved over the highs. Now I need to see some continuation to that. As you noticed, I bought it over 1960. Assuming it's going to move over the highs, I'll talk about that later. Right now, look at RYB. I'm going to short it right here under $16. About to short RYB. RYB is down today. Okay, come on. Just under 60 now. And look at Riot. Riot just moved over $20. I need some continuation. It's not enough. My target is approximately 2020. I don't want to see any pullback now. I don't want to see any pullback now. Please don't pull back. Still is holding high. Oh, look at this huge pullback. I hate it. This is a huge pullback. That's a $1 and more pullback. Luckily, it was supported at $19. When you see a move like that, never let it shake you out. Always look for the pullback after the pullback. This bottoming tail that you're seeing here, that should be your stop, just beneath this bottoming tail. You never ever move out on a pullback like that. A quick downside move should never take you out of the game. Never. And we also have the whole number there, 19, that should help us. Should help us. Now I won't see it coming back to the highs. Most of the time, if you're going to see something like that, that means one huge seller, some fat finger who sold a large quantity. And the only thing, well, 99% of the time, it will come back to the highs. So never let a shakeout like this take you out of the game. At the same time, as you can see here, RYB is not doing well. My stop is just over the highs. Now let's talk again about Riot. I mentioned earlier that I moved in at the 1960 something before it moved over the highs. That was approximately 10 cents before it moved over the highs. It's a very important lesson. You try to move in. If you can, you can't always do that, but you try to move in before a stock is moving over the highs. I know everybody's telling you otherwise. It is not true. You try to move in before it moves over the highs. RYB, I'm about to move out. It's moving over the highs, just moved. Okay, I'm out. I have a loser now. RYB. Let's go back again. Talk about Riot here. You move in before a stock hits a new high because you should expect what is expected. Meaning, you take a look at the stock at the point where you think that there's an 80% chance for the stock to move over the highs, that's where you click the button. And right now it looks to me like it's going to go over the high, so I'm adding another 2,000 shares, there we go, before it moved over the highs. So again, I'm expecting it the way it looks right now, failed to move lower, came back up to move over the highs, so I just added another 2,000 shares. You have to remember that trading is not about what you see. Trading is about expectations. Now look at Riot again. Don't you expect now to see it over the highs really soon? If it's going to move over 1990, I'm going to add. Just did. Adding. Now, once it moved over 1990, it's probably going to move. Yes, it did. Over 20. Look at that. New high in Riot. Amazing. Now I have 6,000 shares scaling in all the time when I expect it to move over the highs. I need to see Riot over the highs once more in order to take my partial. The high is 2024. There we go. There we go. Over the highs. Good. Over 30. Over 2040. About to sell now. Sold 5,600 shares. Left just 400 shares. A great trade in Riot. And again, scaling in when you expect the next move. You always take a look at the stock, the way it behaves. Once you see the point where you can scale in and add a little bit more when you expect it to move to a new high, you can do that. And once it gets to your target, always remember, take your partial, put the danger behind you. I'm about to reshort RYB. It's a nice reversal point here, and look at the view up. Once it moves under the view up, it's going to come down. Looks good now. About to short. 1,000 shares shorted. Okay, just moved, touched, in fact, the view up here. Should come down now. Now, that's my second trade in RYB, therefore, very, very small size. My first trade, doesn't matter if it was a winner or it was a loser, means that I am biased. It means that my second trade is either a revenge trade or a trade if I was up, which is not the case in RYB. So the second trade sometimes makes you feel like you're invincible. So in both cases, mentally speaking, you shouldn't take the second trade. Or if you do take a second trade like I just did, you take it with smaller size because you're biased. I mean, in the back of my head, it's either I'm feeling invincible or I'm feeling like I need a revenge trade. So whenever you do that, always take your second trade with a smaller size. So just moved in 1,000 shares short RYB. RYB is doing okay. That's a 30 cent winner so far. At any pullback, I'm going to cover just now. Okay, 20 something cent winner in RYB. Just move down under the view up here. And again, a stock that is down 40% should continue moving down. So that was a nice trade. I'm doing okay for the day. One loser in RYB, second one is a very small winner. Still down, as you can see here, $1,700 my total in RYB today, but I had a huge winner in Riot, up $2,400. Thank you very much for watching and see you next week.
Thank you for watching my video. Do you have what it takes to become a trader? I would like to invite you to take my free trading challenge. If you succeed, I will fund you. You will get free access to a $14,000 trading account which you can trade from home and earn 70% of the profits you generate. No risk, no cost. Just click here and join now. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel here. If you have any questions, please use the comments below.